जैन स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम बैक। टुडे वी विल स्टडी द कंक्लूडिंग पार्ट ऑफ द स्टोरी द लास्ट लेसन बाय अनीश जंग। एंड इफ टाइम परमिट्स अस देन वी विल ऑल्सो डिस्कस सम इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द चैप्टर। सो let us begin today, and first of all let me share the remaining part of the story on your screen. See children, here it is, and these are the questions we will discuss. That some of the important questions are also there. You can see that question number 2, question number 3, these are the important questions we will discuss later on, but just you keep that in your mind. And now that we are going to begin from here today, as that in our previous class we have studied till here, and as I told you that this is the last sentence is very important. Even that long answer type question can also be asked on the basis of this statement. Okay, now like they talk endlessly in a spiral, you know, continuously they kept on talking to the author, and the central point of their conversation, their discussion was that moves from poverty to apathy, to greed, and to injustice. Those Bengal makers were poverty stricken from generations. They were not able to come out from the wave of the poverty and apathy. The reason is because there is the apathy of the officials, of the bureaucrats, of the politicians, of the lawmakers. They were quite indifferent. They were not interested to take those 20,000 children out of their poverty, out of those hazardous industry. And the greed, and why, what was the reason? Because they are greedy people. Even the middlemen, the agents who were, you know, getting money from the factory owners for engaging the children into Bengal making industry. And middlemen means who trap the children. And apart from them, that there are policemen that who have the responsibility to follow the law and order. There is law against the child labor, but since the policemen also are not interested to eradicate that law, and it is because of their permission that you know, those children, 20,000 children, are working in that hazardous industry like glass bangles and some other industries also, that children are engaged because law are not implemented strictly, and to injustice. And in this way, that injustice is being done against this child, this poor people, means all these people altogether exploit them. Now let us see that what happens next. So by giving the example, if this statement can be asked, that elaborate or elucidate okay in 120 to 150 words even. So in that way, by giving the examples from the story, you can elaborate it. Now let us see the next last paragraph, and remember student, this last paragraph is very important. So each and every line of this last paragraph you should understand well. So let us see that what happens here in the last paragraph. Listening to them, I see two distinct worlds. One of the family caught in the web of poverty, burdened with the stigma of caste in which they are born. The other is a vicious circle of the Sahukars. Now see, first of all, this is the question means which you know that recently, just I think 2 years back, it was this question was asked in board examination. What are the two distinct world which were existing in Firozabad? So this you have to focus on it, that listening to them while she was talking to the young men of the Bengal maker's family, that after listening them, that author, I means Anish Jung, the author, realized that there are two distinct, two different world, two distinct world, clearly two clearly different world, two clearly different groups were existing there in Firozabad. And who were these two different world? One, this, and one group means one world belongs to the Bengal makers. Means one group is that who which has been caught in the web of poverty, who are suffering from poverty generation after generation, and they are burdened by the stigma. Stigma means that is the a disgrace, we can say, and they are burdened by the stigma of caste in which they are born. Stigma of caste in which they are born because they are born in the family of Bengal makers, and that's why means those who belong to the Bengal makers family, they are perpetually poor. They are unable to come out from the web of poverty. Means they are poverty-stricken people. Means even after working very hard, they are unable to come out from the poverty. They remain poor generation after generations. And this is the first group. First world means first world is the Bengal makers of Firozabad, and the other vicious circle of the Sahukars. And the other world is the two distinct world. First world is the first group is the Bengal makers group, and the other is the vicious, the villainous circle, the evil people. Means the villainous circle of the Sahukars. And who are they in this vicious circle? In that group means who exploit those those poor Bengal makers. They are the Sahukars. Sahukars means money lender, and who lend money if they need, and then later on charge a heavy interest. In this way they exploit those poor Bengal makers. And the middlemen means those agents that who trap the Bengal makers' children in their childhood, and that engage them into the bangle making industry. And the policemen, and then policemen who have the responsibility to follow, to enforce law and order. Means there is a law against the child labor, but they are also they have also joined hands with this vicious circle, and that's why they are unable to come out from the poverty. And apart from these people, the keepers of law, the bureaucrats means officials, leaders, and the politicians, all these people are belong to the second group, that is the vicious circle. And they all together have joined hand, and jointly they exploit to those poor people of bengal makers, and together they have imposed, as that author says, that together they have, means all these people, sahukars, money lenders, middlemen, policemen, bureaucrats, politicians, means they together have imposed the baggage, means the burden, on the child that he cannot put down, because they trap the children of this of bengal maker's family right from their childhood, and after that they put such a heavy load on that before, even after being adult, they were unable to come out from that, but they cannot put down that load, that burden, and before he is aware, he accepts it as naturally as his father. And when they are aware of it, when they are able to understand their trick, that they are trapped, by that time it is too late, because they become adult and they have so many responsibilities, and that other options of taking training or doing effort for trying to get any other job, means all their initiatives, all their options are stopped. In this way, that this vicious circle, vicious group, are able to exploit them from generations. And to do anything else would mean to dare. And then further, the author says that to do anything else means to search for any other job, or to do any other job means to dare, and daring is not part of his growing up, and daring was the not part of their growing up, because they are trapped since their childhood. So when they become adult, by that time it is too late, and all the initiatives of them are stopped. In this way, that after that they are unable to do anything, they are unable to dare, they don't have courage, they are so much burdened that they are unable to show any courage to do anything, to learn anything, or to search any other job except making bangles. When I sense a flash of it in Mukesh, I am cheered. And then here the author says, when she gets a hope, in a light of hope in Mukesh, who was a boy, who was a Bengal child, Bengal maker, I am cheered. She was quite happy to see that, because Mukesh was ready to dare. Mukesh was ready to take initiative to do something else rather than continue their family business of bangle making. I want to be a motor mechanic, he repeats. When it was asked to him, that he repeatedly said that he wants to be a motor mechanic. He does not want to continue the family business of making bangles, rather he wants to do something else. And he said that he wants to be a motor mechanic, he said repeatedly. So he will go to a garage and learn. Even that he was ready to work work very hard, even he was ready to go to garage and learn to get the training. And but the garage is long away from his home. I will walk. When that it was asked to him that the garage is far away from him, where that garage means that where vehicles are repaired, then when it was asked to him that the garage is a long way from his home, then I will walk, he insists. Then he said, he insisted that he was ready to walk, means he was ready to do go up to any extent to get the training of being a motor mechanic, and I will walk. Then he said that he was ready to walk to cover the distance. Do you also dream of flying a plane? When Arthur asks that, do you have a bigger dream than that? Means, do you also dream of flying a plane? Means, when she asks that, does he want to become a pilot and wants to fly a plane? He is suddenly silent. He became silent. He did not answer. No, he said. Then he became silent, and then he answered that no, he had not thought of being a pilot or flying a plane. And staring at the ground, in his small murmur there is an embarrassment that has not yet turned into regret. You know that when means it was his answer was quite matured, his approach was quite matured. And when he told that he does not want to dream of flying a plane, because that his approach was very matured and practical, as he says that in his small murmur there is an embarrassment that has not yet turned into regret. He was embarrassed, but he was not regretted. He was not hopeless. Still, that he had hope to fulfill his dream. And he is content to dream of cars that he sees hurling down the streets of the town. And because few airplanes fly over Firozabad. And he is content, he is satisfied to dream of cars that he sees hurling. Why he was not ready to dream for the flying a plane? Because his approach was quite positive, quite practical and matured, because he could think that for being a pilot he requires more education, he requires more money, and the kind of qualification is required to be a pilot he cannot afford, he cannot he does not have. And that's why he knows it very well that he is satisfied to dream of cars that he sees hurling, moving fastly down the streets of his town, because every day he could see that the cars were hurling down in his street. So his approach was very practical, and it is within his reach to be a motor mechanic. To drive a car was in his reach, and that's why he was thinking about to be a motor mechanic, to drive a car instead of flying a plane. And because that few airplanes fly over Firozabad, means he had hardly seen any airplanes flying over Firozabad. That's why that it can be said that his approach to choose to be a motor mechanic, to drive a car, to become a driver of car, was quite matured, practical and positive. Okay, now here that we came to an end of this chapter in this way. And here you can also see that there are some questions. Three questions in the column thing, as you read, these questions can be written in 30 to 40 words. These are short answer type questions, like what makes the city of Firozabad famous? You know it very well. The answer, even you can give the answer in one word, Firozabad. That is the sufficient. Your answer is absolutely correct, but until you write, you complete the word limit, you can't get full marks. So that's why you will have to make the crown to complete 30 to 40 words word limit. And now the second one, you also know the answer, that mentioned the hazards of working in the glass bangles industry. This is important question, has already been asked in board examination as a short answer type question, but it is important for both, for short answer type question as it can also be asked as long answer type question, to answer in 120 to 150 words. So remember students, that you will have to do the effort, means you should have the confidence that if it is required, you can elaborate it up to 150 words as well. So hazards of working in the glass bangles industry, so many hazards we have already discussed, that and the workers in the glass bangles industry means those children, about 20,000 children work in those glass bangles factory, and they work in a very subhuman conditions. They face many health hazards. Even they go blind with the dust from polishing the glass of bangles, and they have to work near the very high temperature around the furnaces, which is quite unbearable. They have to sit in the dingy cells, and most of the daylight time they have to spend in darkness. Apart from that, that the polish pop, that the polish of glasses are also harmful. There are so many. Means this, these are the important points. You can mention these points if it is required. If this question is asked as 150 words, you just have to elaborate it by giving the reference of the story. So this question is important one. You can mark it as an important question. Now you can see the third one, that how is Mukesh's attitude to his situation different from that of his family, because he has courage. He is ready to dare to do something else. Means he is ready to work very hard. He is quite determined about his dream to be a motor mechanic. Means he is ready to work very hard. He is ready even to walk to cover the distance from his home to the garage, and he was quite determined to be motor mechanic, and that his approach is quite practical, quite matured, and that it is hoped that if he is ready to do this all, because he does not want to continue the family lineage of working in the bangle industry. So that's why he's in this way, that his approach is different. Something like that, in your own words, you can, by putting these points, you can also complete this answer. And now, let us see, students, some important questions are also here. Understanding the text, these are the long answer type questions. What could be some of the reasons for the migration of the people from villages to cities? There are so many points. If this question, generally this question will be asked in this question requires 150 word, 120 to 150 words answer. So for that you can give many examples, and but especially you will have to give the reference from the story, that the people, rag picker Sahib's family migrated from Dhaka, Bangladesh to Simhapuri, Delhi, in search of job, education, job opportunities, these are health, better health facilities, better lifestyle. There might be so many reasons. You will have to at least four reasons you will have to give, and you can by giving the reference of the story. Don't forget to give the reference of the story of Sahib-e-Alam and his family and other rag pickers. Why they left their house? They're from Dhaka, Bangladesh. Means those reasons should also be mentioned in the answer. Now, would you agree that the promises made to poor children are rarely kept? Important question. And why do you think this happens in the incidents narrated in the text? You know that when you can also give for this, that you can also give the reference of the narrator when she asks, when she promises to Sahib that if she opens a school, will he come to study there? Then he was quite hopeful. Next time when he meets that, he asked that, is your school ready? And she felt embarrassed. So like that, because she knows that she had made a false promise, which was not which she was not willing to fulfill. So like that, there are so many. The world is full of such kind of false promises. So some other examples also you can cite and complete your word limit. But don't forget to give this example, this reference from the story, because it is always better if you are going to write any of the answer for getting better marks. Don't forget to give the examples from the story. If it is possible, it is better if you can quote those lines, those sentences, those statements. These are the key factors to get full marks in your examination. So now let us see that the third one. What forces conspired to keep the workers in the bangle industry of Firozabad? You know that just in last paragraph, just you can go through the last paragraph. Means easily you will be able to get the answer of these questions. No need to discuss, because that in last paragraph of the second part of the story, that which we just studied today itself, you will be able to get the answers. Sahukars, money lenders, bureaucrats, politicians. Okay, so and some others. These are the forces conspire. They conspired to keep the workers in the bangle industry. They put the burden on the child right from their childhood, and they are unable to put that down. Means all those things you can give such kind of reference, and you can complete the word limit. And now that, so this question is rather out of these three, this is the most important question, this one, the third one. So but remember, students, I keep on repeating you that reminding you that you must write the answers in your own words. Take the points, study the chapters, and you can get very, very good marks in board examinations even. And now see that, talking about the text, so from here also three questions are given there. How, in your opinion, can Mukesh realize his dream? So you can also give your opinion. His approach is quite practical, and he was ready to work very hard. Okay, then he wants to be a motor mechanic. He wants to drive a car. He does not want to fly a plane, because that it is the maturity of his mind. Even though he is a boy, but he shows a lot of maturity, and his choice is quite practical to be a motor mechanic, because it is it is within his reach. So by giving that example, that some other points also you can add from your side and complete the word limit. this answers also required 120 to 150 words. And mention the hazards of working in the glass bangle industry. We have already discussed this question as a short answer type question, and I have told you that question can also be asked as a long answer type questions, because here that this is asked as long answer type question. So by giving those points, you can elaborate your answer and complete the word limit. And why should child labor be eliminated? This is a creative part. This is a part of your creative writing. Child labor for this, child labor means that on this topic, even that article can be asked. Article can be asked, even that other long answer type questions from writing sections can also be asked on the basis of this. So this is the creative part of the writing. Adding your own points, you can complete this word limit, and you also have to write in 120 to 150 words. So I think that you have understood the complete story. Well, that story is important, and I hope that you will be able to give the answer. But you write those important questions and their answers in your notebook, school notebook. So I think in this way that we came to an end of chapter number 2, The Lost Spring. And in our next class, we will study another chapter. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.